Hey guys, if you haven't met me yet, my name is Emery. I am 24 and I identify as a non-binary transmasculine person, which for me means that I don't really fall on the ends of male or female, but I fall much farther to the male side in my mind than I was identified at birth. So I kind of have transitioned to a more masculine appearance and feeling rather than a more feminine one. If you want to learn more about me, we made a video last week that has a bunch of questions just kind of talking about us a little bit, but not too in depth, so you might want to subscribe if you want to learn more about me or us in the future. So today I'm going to talk about my experience with top surgery. I haven't had top surgery yet. I'm going for a consultation on October 2nd, which is 1 week from today. So, wow, that's soon. So, obviously, if you're squeamish hearing about things like surgery, you might want to click away now. It's a content warning. So we'll be looking into kind of what I'll be going through, how much things are going to cost, how it's going to go, that kind of thing. So I'm going to go into some things, some worries and fears and expectations that I have going into this consultation. So what a top surgery consultation is you go into the office of the surgeon you're planning on going to for the top surgery, and they tell you what kind of surgery you're going to need, how much it's going to cost, what the prep will look like, maybe talk about how your insurance might cover it and that sort of thing. So they just look at you and see what you need, and then you leave with a better idea of what you're going in for. I want to explain why I'm making this video. So for me, I have top dysphoria, which top in trans terms means this area of your body. And so dysphoria means a discomfort with the difference between your gender identity and how your body is. In this case, I'm talking about bodily dysphoria, so there's a disconnect for me between what my brain feels like my body should look like and what my body actually looks like. So I have this very, very intense feeling of anxiety and discomfort about what my body currently looks like. So to deal with my dysphoria with my chest, what I do currently is bind, and binding is basically compressing the chest as much as you can to make it look flat. If you've never seen one before, this is what a binder looks like. It's kind of like a half of a tank top. I usually wear a black one, but the nude colored one is easier to see kind of the seams and things. So it kind of is this stretchy material that's like shirts you'd wear to the gym, but on the inside, I flipped it inside out. This is a canvas piece, it's not stretchy at all. Doesn't go anywhere. That's the part that goes on your chest, and this is the part that goes on your back. So this part is stretchy, but because this part is so tight against you, it compresses your back as well, so everything kind of hurts. But that's what I use, that's what I wear under my clothes instead of like sports bras or whatever. And you kind of pull it on like a tank top, so it just compresses from here to here and just pulls everything in super tight so you can't really breathe. It hurts your ribs and your back. It's not comfortable, which is why people go toward a surgical option, because it's not really feasible to bind for your entire life. It can really mess up your ribs and your organs that are within whatever area you're binding, so you try to get away from that eventually. For me, chest dysphoria and binding make my life difficult, because I'd rather just be able to put my clothes on and not have to worry about how my chest looks in certain clothes. Those binders are about $35 if you get the half tank. I use a company called GC2B. It's one of the better, safer companies, I think, and it's run by actual trans people, so it's for trans people by trans people, which is really good. Though those binders are really helpful and the company is really nice, it still is an uncomfortable thing to do, so I can't really go and swim comfortably, and I can't really wear my clothes all that comfortably, but it does definitely help day to day. But top surgery is the ultimate goal. So that being said, my plan is to go and get double incision top surgery, which I've mentioned top surgery a million times. Basically, it's a double mastectomy, but top surgery is the trans term for how to say that. When we say top surgery, it usually means the removal of breast tissue and then reshaping the chest to make it look more masculine. So there are several other types of top surgery. I'm only going to talk about the one that I'm planning on getting because of my chest size and skin elasticity and stuff like that. I'm only going to be eligible for double incision top surgery. So for me, that means there will be an incision just above my current nipple and one at the very base of my chest. And then they remove the nipple, take the nipples off, both of them, resize them separately, and then they take all the breast tissue out and close the incision, so your chest would be completely flat at that point. Then they take the nipple grafts, they cut a little space for it on your chest, and then put the nipple back onto your chest so that it's flat, and they reposition where the nipples go so that they're more masculine. Women's nipples are kind of more central and lower, so they kind of bring them up and to the sides to make them look more masculine. This surgery is actually an outpatient surgery, so you'll go in. It takes, I think, on average about 4 hours to do the surgery. You're in the recovery room for probably an hour-ish, depending on how your surgery went, and then you leave and you get to drive home or to a hospital, and then you have to return a week later to check on your incisions. Because of the travel, leaving where you have surgery, going home, and then coming back, I wanted to go somewhere that was closer to my house. The closest surgeon that I found that had really good results is Dr. Beverly Fisher in Maryland. I live in Virginia, so Maryland was a pretty quick-ish option for me. So, though there are more closer surgeons who are near me, they don't have as many results, and the results that I've seen aren't very good, so I don't want to go to some random plastic surgeon that's close to me just because they're close to me. So I decided to go to the closest one who was still good, which would be Dr. Beverly Fisher in Maryland. I've received an email from their office saying how much I should expect the surgery to be, which they quoted at $8,500, but I believe they kind of adjust that price depending on your situation. If you have a really large chest or a very uneven chest or something like that, where they need to kind of restructure things a little bit more than normal, it might be a little more. I'm not sure if that'll be exactly the same when I go or if they're gonna adjust the price a little bit. So I wanted to talk about some hopes and fears about the consultation because I think a lot of people don't talk about the consultation part, they only talk about the actual surgery part. So what I'm worried about going into the consultation is talking about kind of the bad effects of surgery, so things like complications with the surgery, if my chest could possibly have uneven scarring, or the nipples are uneven, or the wrong size, or if they can't resize a certain way that I want them to, and that kind of thing. So my worries are kind of asking a lot of questions that I want to know about, and them having answers that I don't really want to hear. I think that would be kind of like a letdown if I go and I want to figure out things and be excited about these answers, and then they give me what I don't want, but I still need to go have top surgery to help my brain. So that'll be a little scary for me. As far as my hopes for the consultation, it's kind of the opposite of all of those fears. So I really hope I can walk in, talk to them about my surgery, and ask all the questions I want to ask and get a positive response. So maybe my surgery will be a little less expensive than I expected. Maybe she says that my chest is really good for this type of surgery and it'll be really easy to do even scars and good nipple placement and all of that stuff. So I'm hoping for that kind of stuff, but I think all the hopes are pretty obvious, so I'm not gonna list them all here. So that's about that. If you have any questions, leave them below in the comment box. I'd love to answer any questions that you might have about me or top surgery in general, or I can make another video about other types of top surgeries, that kind of thing. I'm going to vlog the day of my consultation. I can't vlog while I'm in the actual consultation itself. So I'm going to vlog a little bit on the way to the consultation, and then I guess either on my way home or when I get home, I'll kind of talk about more about, like, in depth what they told me, what's changed since last time I talked about this. And it'll kind of just be an update. I'll figure out some things. I don't think I'll have a surgery date at that point, but it's a possibility, so I'll update when we get there. So I have a top surgery fundraising page. I'll link it in the description or maybe in an annotation somewhere in here, where I'm raising money because obviously $8,500 is not cheap and I don't believe it'll be covered by insurance. I'm trying to be safe and raise as much money as possible. I think I'm about a tenth of the way to my goal, so if you'd like to help me, go and check out that fundraising page, maybe donate a dollar or something. Any amount of money will help, I promise. Thank you guys so much for watching. Definitely like and comment if you have questions, like I said. Subscribe to the channel if you want to see updates and other types of videos. And yeah, have a good week. I'll talk to you guys next week.